Hi guys, welcome back to Shopify Liquid Programming YouTube series. In this video, we will learn how to work with Shopify if and else condition in Liquid Programming. In previous two videos, we learned how to assign a value to a variable. We learned how to add comments in Liquid Programming code. And we also learned how to do addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So those were the basic things which we learned in our previous two videos. I'll put the link in the description so you guys can follow along. Let's jump into the third one. So guys, that's what we learned in our previous videos. Now we will play with if and else condition. In order to work with if else, that's how if works in Shopify, and that's our condition. For now, I'm just adding a name condition, as we can use logical operators for condition like equals to, less than, more than, etc., etc. And we will end our if with end if. So that's how the basic PHP if statement works in Shopify. Now let's compare two numbers which we have here. So when we have number 1, which is equal to 6, and number 2, which is equal to 12. Now let's compare these two numbers and let's find out which one is the greater number. So that's the basic if condition which I'm showing you how it will work. So let's compare that. If number 2 is greater than number 1, then we will print. So let's this is the greater number. So number 2 is the greater one. And we will also use else. Where we will mention that number 1 is the greater 1. So obviously in this case number 2 is greater 1. We are just checking if our condition is properly added and if it's working or not. So let's make it a little bigger by applying h1. Again, you should have the basic knowledge of HTML and CSS, or if you have basic knowledge of JavaScript, then that's good as well. If you don't know about HTML and CSS, I already have created courses for you guys. I'll put the link in the description so you can easily learn. You can become a zero to hero in HTML. Okay, so we are getting error. We added a space in between the variable, which is the wrong thing. Okay, that's fixed now. Now hit save and let's see if our condition is working. I'll go back to my page and hit refresh. And here we go. It's telling that 12 is the greater one. Number 2 was 12, and which is the greater one? Shopify told us. And now that tells us that our if condition is working fine. Now let's revert the value and make the number 160. And now let's see what happens. Now it should say that number 1 is the greater one. Now it will skip this because this condition is false now, and it will not perform this action. And now it will move on to else and do and work with else statement. Now hit save and hit refresh. And here we go. As you can see, our calculation which we did in our previous video, division multiplication, has also changed because we changed the value of our variables here. And now it's telling us that 60 is the greater one. Now is our else condition is also working. Similarly, we can use less than sign. So that's the operator for greater than, and that is for less than. Now it will revert the condition. As we can see, now it will check that if number 2 is less than number 1. As we can see that number 2 is smaller than number 1, which is 60. Now it will revert the condition. It will just tell us which number is the smaller one by adding the less than value. Now if I hit save and hit refresh, it will tell us which variable is the smaller one, as it's now telling us that 12 is the smaller one between number 2 and number 1. Now similarly, we have equals to operator, which will compare the two values if these two values are equal to each other or not. Now, as we can see that number 2 and number 1 is not equal to each other, it will make this condition false and print this statement, where we can just write values are not equal to each other. Values are equal to each other. So it will print. If this condition is true, it will print this line, and if this condition is not true, which is else, it will print this value. Now let's see if it's working properly. Hit save and refresh. Oops. There we go. Now it's telling us that values are not equal to each other. Now if we make the same value in number 2 and hit save, go back and hit refresh. As you can see, it changes the statement, which states values are equal to each other. Okay guys, that's it for our if and else condition. If you still have any confusion, please put your questions on the comment below. I'll make sure to answer them as soon as possible. Also, our next video will be related to how to use Switch in Shopify Liquid programming. So stay tuned and have a nice day.